In this lecture, we will learn about how to make a computer game for tic-tac-toe. So you must all have played this tic-tac-toe game, okay, where we put X and zeros, and okay, so first player puts X, then let's say you place a zero, then again I place an X, you put a zero. So what will happen? I put like this and so on. So if you have now, let's say this one puts here a zero, then you put it X here, you win. Okay, so I hope you all know this tic-tac-toe, but how will you write a code that will make the computer play tic-tac-toe for you with another player? Okay, and it will always win. That's important. Okay, so tic-tac-toe, we can use Minimax algorithm to code tic-tac-toe. So what's our aim? So our aim is to build an unbeatable game for tic-tac-toe, isn't it? We always want that our computer should win the game. And for that, so create an algorithm that could calculate all the possible moves available for the computer. So what we want, best way is that, okay, the computer, I know it has a lot of processing power, memory, let it search all the possibilities and then find which is the best move it can make. But what is the best move? How will the computer decide? So choose some metric to determine the best move, and we will see how it does. So Minimax algorithm can do the job for us. Okay, so let's try to see how it is done. Okay, so how to play a game, okay, how to play a perfect game of tic-tac-toe. If I play perfectly every time I play with either win, so then if I play perfectly I win the game. Okay, so it says now that if I'm playing perfectly I will always win the game or I will draw. When will I draw? Because if the other player is also perfect in the game, then we can only draw the game. Okay, how might we describe the situation? Now quantify the situation. So we will assign, let's say we have a move, many possibilities are there. So we will assign values to it. If by making some move, I'm sure I will win, I will give a plus 10 to it. If the other player can win, I will give a minus 10 to that move. And if it will only lead to a draw, then I will assign a 0 to it. Okay, so these are the possible moves. Okay, and let's try to see. So if I win, I get 10 points. If I lose, I lose 10 points. So minus 10. If I draw, if that move will take me to a draw, I will give it a 0. So now we have a situation where we can determine where to go. So I will always try to, as a player, I will always try to take a path that will always give me 10 points. And the opponent will want what? He will want that I lose and I get minus 10. So what do we know about the opponent? Okay, so the opponent is also the smartest person. He is also smart and he never wants to lose. Well, we should assume that O is also playing to win this game. But relative to us, I want plus 10. My win, he wants me to get minus 10 that I lose. Okay, so how will that happen? The key to Minmax algorithm is that both players will move back and forth. And what will I do? Where the player whose turn it is, he desired to pick the move which wins game for him. Okay, so first move is for me, I put X. Okay, then I have now how many possibilities? Now I have done, okay, so initially I had, when I played, I had 9 possibilities. I put it here. Then the other player O has got 8 possibilities and he will try to find the best possible way so that I lose or at least I will draw. In turn, the scores for each player available moves, okay, and the scores for opposing players move again. Okay, so he plays now, let's say he O puts here. Now again I will try, okay, out of these many places, where should I put so that I'm sure I will win or at least I will not lose. Then if let's say I place it here, O will try to think, okay, where should he put so that he always wins or at least he doesn't lose. Okay, so if the game is over, so this is the algorithm. Okay, but before that, let's try to see one example. Okay, so let's say we are in this state. Okay, so my state is this one. The game, I am X, okay, and my opponent is O. So we have made some moves. Okay, so what happens now? So this is there. Yeah, okay, so this is the place. Okay, I am starting at this place. So I have X and other player is O. So now it is my move. So we have already got 6 out of 9 places filled. So now these are the 3 options I can play. So if I put X here, which is this branch, I win. Okay, so I get a plus 10, bingo. Otherwise, if I put X here, nothing great is happening. Okay, and if I put in this place also, till now nothing is happening, but these two points, places, again moves can decide. So I branch out further. So these two I copy here. Let's try to see. So these two are the moves from the previous place. Now I have already played my turn. It's O's turn. So O, he is also always plays to win, and he is smart enough. I'm making sure that he is the smartest person, so he doesn't make a mistake. So in this case, he will just put a move here, then he wins. So this, out of these two possibilities, if he put O here, he wins. So minus 10 for me. Now if O puts here, then I again get a chance and I can play and then I win. Okay, so this is good for me. But the thing is, when it's O's chance and he is a smart player who doesn't lose or like to lose, he will always use this chance to win. So overall, I will give a minus 10 to this, because in the second move, O will obviously win. He will not give me this chance to win. In this part, again, O can put here or here. If he puts here, again, he wins. So I get a minus 10. If he puts here, then I get a chance to put X here and I win. But again, if O is smart, he will always put this move and he will win. So O will always choose to move the result so that I get minus 10. Okay, so this is the case and how I give the points. Okay, so now you understand this, and then we will move on. So we come to this presentation. So if the game is over, return. Okay, so now let's try to see. So now this is the algorithm. If the game is over, return the scores from X perspective, if he wins or loses. Otherwise, get a list of new game states. So if it is over, game is over, then return what was the score. Minus 10, I lost. Plus 10, I win. 0, or draw. Okay, but otherwise, if I have a move, then new game state. So try out all possibilities and branch out, and finally see that where I can win, which is the most best possible way. And for each states, add the min-max result. So it's basically recursive. First give yourself the chance, keep, then in the next branch out and see what is the O's move. Always take the O's move that is best for him and then decide. Okay, so it's recursive and it flips back forth between X and O, where I am X. So we will try to see the algorithm again. We have, this is the state of the algorithm, let's say, and from here I will play with Minimax. Okay, so what will happen? So in this state, now it's my turn. I can put my X at these three places. So these are the branchings. I put X here, I win. I put X at this place, this is there. So again, what, it, there's nothing here, so need to branch out. Now Y's turn. Okay, so basically O's turn. So he has two places to put. If he puts O here, he wins. So it's minus 10 for me. If he puts O here, then I win. But O is smart and he will not allow this move. So this is not a good move for me. If I put X here, across here, then O will get chances here. So now what happens? If O puts here, then I win, but he has a chance here and he will win. So this is minus 10 for me. So now what will happen? So I have basically for these three branching, I was playing here. So I will give plus 10 here. I have minus 10 here because I will lose here. He will not allow me this chance. Oh, and I will lose here also because he will not allow me this chance. He will win here itself in this next step. So minus 10, minus 10, plus 10. So this is the step I will take and I will win. Okay. So this is Minimax algorithm. So you play forth backward in between X and O. X, you are there. So you branch out all the possibilities and see in which case you are winning, you are getting the highest point. You play only those moves. Okay. So this is there. I hope you understand this. Thanks a lot.